Good evening, students. Today we are going to study about trigonometric identities. This is my fourth video on trigonometry. You will find the link for the previous three videos in the comment section or in the description section. And if you visit my channel, you will find other videos on mathematics also. Now, what is a trigonometric identity? We know that an equation is called an identity when it is true for all values of the variables involved. Similarly, an equation involving trigonometric ratios of an angle is called a trigonometric identity if it is true for all values of the angles involved. Now, let's take a right angle triangle ABC, which is right angled at B, and we have taken the base angle C as theta. Now, in this right angle triangle ABC, we can say AB square plus BC square is equal to AC square. From where do we get this relationship? Yes, this is the Pythagoras theorem. According to the Pythagoras theorem, we can say that the square of the hypotenuse is equal to the sum of the squares of the other two sides. Now, if we divide both the sides of the equation by AC square, then what will happen? Then we'll get AB square by AC square plus BC square by AC square equal to AC square by AC square. We have just divided both the sides of the equal to sign with AC square. Now, if you look at the angle theta, what will be the value of sine theta? Well, sine theta is perpendicular upon hypotenuse. So, sine theta will be AB by AC. And we know that cos theta is base by hypotenuse. So, cos theta will be BC by AC. So, we can replace these values in the equation. So, AB square by AC square can be replaced by sin square theta, and BC square by AC square can be replaced by cos square theta. So, we get sin square theta plus cos square theta equal to 1. So, this is the first trigonometric identity which we have got here, which we have proved. So, this is true, this relationship sin square theta plus cos square theta equal to 1. This is true for all theta such that theta lies between 0 and 90 degree. So, this is called a trigonometric identity. Thus, we get our first identity sin square theta plus cos square theta equal to 1. Now, in class 10, you will be using three identities. Rather, you will be learning three identities, three trigonometric identities. So, the first one we have already seen how it is proved, and the remaining two you can prove in the similar fashion. The second one, 1 plus tan square theta equal to sec square theta, and the third is 1 plus cot square theta equal to cosec square theta. Now, while solving the questions, you will see that we use these identities in different forms. Like in the first identity, if I transfer cos square theta to the other side, then the identity will become sin square theta equal to 1 minus cos square theta. If I transfer sin square theta to the other side, then it becomes cos square theta equal to 1 minus sin square theta. So, we can use any form of the identity as per the requirement of the question. Similarly, 1 plus tan square theta equal to sec square theta. From here also, we can get two more formulae. That is, tan square theta equal to sec square theta minus 1, and sec square theta minus tan square theta equal to 1. And from the third one also, we can get two more possibilities. That is, cot square theta equal to cosec square theta minus 1, and cosec square theta minus cot square theta equal to 1. So, basically, you must remember the main three identities. If you remember these three identities, then you can get the remaining ones from here. So, these three identities are very important, and you must keep this in mind that this is a very important topic, and in the examination, you will surely get either a 3 marks question or a 4 marks question from this topic, trigonometric identities. Now let's solve some questions based on these identities. So today's first question, prove that cosec A minus cot A whole square equal to 1 minus cos A by 1 plus cos A. Now here you must remember these are proof questions. So either you have to solve the left hand side to get the right hand side, or you will solve the right hand side to get the left hand side. And in some cases we solve the right hand side and come to a certain conclusion, and we solve the left hand side and come to a certain conclusion, and then we see that both the results are same, and we can say that LHS is equal to RHS, hence proved. But you must remember that while solving such questions, you must never transfer terms from one side to the other, because these are proof questions. So you cannot transfer terms from one side of the equal to sign to the other. Okay, now here in this question, we will start from the left hand side and arrive at the right hand side. So the left hand side is cosec A minus cot A whole square. Now what is cosec A? Cosec A is the reciprocal of sin A, and cot A is equal to cos A by sin A. So we can use these values in place of cosec A and cot A. So I can write 1 by sin A minus cos A by sin A whole square. Now you can see that the denominators are same for both the fractions. So if I take the LCM, I will get 1 minus cos A by sin A whole square. Now if I take the bracket separately for numerator and denominator, then I'll get 1 minus cos A whole square, and the denominator will be sin square A. Now the denominator is sin square A. Here I can use one identity. I know that sin square A is equal to 1 minus cos square A. So I can replace sin square A by 1 minus cos square A. Now what to do? In the numerator, I have 1 minus cos A whole square. But look at the question. In the question, in the right hand side, I have 1 minus cos A in the numerator. That means till now, I have to the point which I have solved, I have got 1 minus cos A whole square. That means I have got one extra 1 minus cos A which I need to remove. Then I will get the answer. So let's see what to do. Look at the denominator, 1 minus cos square A. It is of the form A square minus B square. 1 and 1 square means the same. So it is of the form A square minus B square. And we know that A square minus B square is equal to A plus B into A minus B. So I can use it over here. As a result, I will get the denominator as 1 plus cos A into 1 minus cos A. And the numerator, I can write 1 minus cos A into 1 minus cos A because it is whole square. Now we can easily eliminate 1 minus cos A from the numerator and denominator. As a result, we are left with 1 minus cos A by 1 plus cos A, which is the right hand side. Thus, you see how we started from the left hand side and we arrived at the right hand side. Initially, these questions may seem a bit complicated, but the more you practice, the more easy they will become. So this topic needs a lot of written practice. Okay, let's move to the next question. Prove that 1 plus sec A by sec A is equal to sin square A by 1 minus cos A. Okay, now here I have sin square A in the right hand side. And I know that sin square A is equal to 1 minus cos square A. So I feel it's better if we start with the right hand side. Then we will be able to use some identity. And if I start from the left hand side, then directly looking at the left hand side, no such identity is coming into my mind. So it's better that we start from the right hand side. So sin square A by 1 minus cos A. Just now I said sin square A is equal to 1 minus cos square A, so I can replace it. Now you see in the previous question also we did this. 1 minus cos square A is similar to A square minus B square. So I can use this identity a square minus b square equal to a plus b into a minus b. So as a result, I get 1 plus cos a into 1 minus cos a by 1 minus cos a. So 1 minus cos a gets eliminated and we are left with 1 plus cos a. Now 1 plus cos a. Cos a is equal to 1 by sec a. So I have replaced cos a by 1 by sec a. Now if I take the LCM, then the denominator becomes sec a and the numerator becomes sec a plus 1, which is the left hand side. So here, starting from the right hand side proved to be easier. So we solved the question just in 3 or 4 steps and it was not at all difficult. So I hope you have understood how we started from the right hand side and we arrived at the left hand side. Okay, let's move to the third. This is a big question. Prove that cosec a minus sin a into sec a minus cos a is equal to 1 by tan a plus cot a. Now here it looks like a bit complicated, but if you look at the terms in the left hand side, cosec a and sin a, they are the reciprocals of each other, and sec a and cos a, they are also reciprocals of each other. One thing you must keep in mind, try to change or reduce the terms into the terms of sin a and cos a, then it becomes easy. In this question, we will solve the left hand side and the right hand side separately and then we will see whether we get the same result. So in the left hand side, we have cosec a minus sin a. Just now I said cosec and sin, they are reciprocals of each other, and sec and cos, they are also reciprocals. So instead of cosec, I can write 1 by sin a, and instead of sec, I can write 1 by cos a. So I'll get 1 by sin a minus sin a and 1 by cos a minus cos a. Now if I take the LCM in both the brackets separately, then I will get, in the first one, I'll get 1 minus sin square a by sin a, and in the second one, I'll get 1 minus cos square a by cos a. Now you, by now I think 1 minus sin square a is familiar to you. It's quite familiar because in the previous two questions we have used the identity. So 1 minus sin square a is cos square a, and just like that 1 minus cos square a is sin square a. So we can replace it. So we'll get cos square a by sin a into sin square a by cos a. So, 1 sin a gets eliminated and 1 cos a also gets eliminated. So, as a result, we have 1 cos a and 1 sin a left in the numerator. So, the left hand side is reduced to cos a sin a. Now, let's see what we can do with the right hand side. Okay. So, tan a and cot a, we can change them in terms of sin a and cos a. We know that tan a is sin a by cos a and cot a is just the reciprocal. Cot a will be cos a by sin a. So we can write it like this, 1 by sin a by cos a plus cos a by sin a. So in the denominator we have two fractions. So let us take the LCM. If I take the LCM, then I'll get cos a sin a, and at the top we'll get sin square a plus cos square a. This entire thing is happening in the denominator and the numerator is 1. Now you remember the first identity which we proved, sin square a plus cos square a. Sin square a plus cos square a is equal to 1. So here we can put the value, and since in the denominator we have a fraction, it will become reciprocal. So we have cos a sin a by sin square a plus cos square a. And since sin square a plus cos square a is equal to 1, so we have cos a plus sin a. Thus you can see that numerator that the LHS and RHS have become equal. Hence we have proved the question. LHS is equal to RHS. So students, I hope these three questions, the way I have solved the three questions, you have understood the process. And you need a lot of practice in this topic. So So please practice these questions, and if you get stuck somewhere, you can write in the comments section, and I will be releasing more videos on this topic with HOTS questions. So if you like this video, please share it amongst your friends and subscribe to my channel. There are more videos on mathematics in my channel. Thank you.